Hey everyone, it's Brooke, and I'm here to do my January book haul. I didn't mean to buy this many books, but I did, so let's just do it. The first book I got was something I requested from the publishers. That book is The Sleep Garden by Jim Krusoe, I think is how you say it. This is published by Tin House. Let's read the blurb sheet. The New York Times Book Review has placed him among the foremost creators of surreal Americana, and the Los Angeles Times calls him a mad scientist, the man behind the curtain. Krusoe does something magical with regular words and regular life. In The Sleep Garden, Krusoe's unique voice and vantage point follows a cast of characters as they explore the boundaries between fact and imagination, life and what lies beyond it. Several of them exist in an underground apartment called The Burrow, essentially in purgatory, and their souls inhabit the enigmatic space between life and death. Interwoven within their stories are those of inhabitants of the living world, a retired sea captain, a psychotic former child star, and the technicians who monitor the burrow. Through this ensemble, Krusoe creates a beautifully intertwined narrative about what constitutes a life, what remains when we die, and even what we might carry with us into the next world. So that sounds pretty flippin' fabulous. Never read anything by Jim Krusoe, but I'm excited to get to this, and I think I'm going to be getting to it in February, so you can just bear with me and wait for my February wrap-up or even individual book review if I feel so inclined. The next book I got was my Book of the Month selection, Book of the Month Club selection, which is an online thing. I'll leave links below if you want to explore it a little bit more. I will tell you that it has been just so much fun. You get a brand new hardcover book every month for $10. So you really can't beat that. This month I chose The Sound of Gravel by Ruth Wariner. This is sort of a memoir about Ruth Wariner's time in growing up on a farm in rural Mexico, where authorities turn a blind eye to the practices of her community. Ruth lives in a ramshackle house without indoor plumbing or electricity. A riveting, deeply affecting true story of one girl's coming of age in a polygamist family. So, one of those religious cult types of deals, which is something I am always interested in, just oddly. I don't know, it captures my attention, so I look forward to seeing this, and it's getting really good reviews. Another book I really just sort of impulse bought this month was after hearing it on the All the Books podcast by Book Riot. It came out in paperback in January. I'd had it kind of on my radar when it was out on hardcover, but just never bit the bullet and bought it. That is Hall of Small Mammals by Thomas Pierce. This is a collection of short stories that are just sort of weird, I think. The stories in Hall of Small Mammals take place at the confluence of the commonplace and the cosmic, the intimate and the infinite. A resurrected woolly mammoth tests a woman's faith. Two sisters trapped in a stranger's pantry fight unknown dangers within themselves and outside the door. A physicist in search of a mysterious and elusive particle is married to two men, one of whom lives only in the world of her dreams. A hot air balloon pilot, a cranky comedian, a fossil hunter, parents and children, brothers and sisters, believers and non-believers. The people in these stories are seeking to understand the absurdity and magnitude of what it means to be good, to be part of a family, to exist in the world, to exist at all. That sounds great. I will be reading this hopefully soon. I'm going to say that about every book. And I can't read all of the books at one time, but I want to read all of them really soon. Next, another new release in January is Mr. Splitfoot by Samantha Hunt. This has been on my wish list for a couple of months now, so I knew I was going to pick it up immediately, especially after hearing several people who I respect really give this high ratings. You should check out Andy's review over at Estella's Revenge, because it really sort of pushed me over the edge, to be honest. She really loved this. I've just started. So, not super far in, but really enjoying it so far. It's this really weird, dark, funny story of a kind of, again, sort of another religious, culty home for children. Follows mainly this girl Ruth and her story and her older sister's story. And there's two intertwined narratives, from when she's young to when she's older. And I don't really feel like you need to know more than that. It's batshit bonkers, and I'm enjoying it. The short story selection for my short story reading group on Goodreads, links below, is In the Country by Mia Alvar. This is, I think, her debut collection. Yes, I think so. It is vividly, unforgettable stories from Mia Alvar, a remarkable new literary talent, vividly give voice to the women and men of the Filipino diaspora. So, yes. Here are exiles, immigrants, and wanderers uprooting their families from the Philippines to begin new lives in the Middle East, the United States, and elsewhere. I have read a little over half of it. It is a longer collection. Have loved every story. Spoilers, I think it's amazing. This is already on the contender for my favorite books of the year. Everyone who's been reading in the group has really, really been taking with it. It has a beautiful spine if you need some extra oomph to get you there. It's blurbed by Celeste Ng, which I think is a really great blurb. I think it's sort of, if you like Everything I Never Knew, I think you would really like this. So good. She writes so well, you guys. Get on the bandwagon. Hop on it. Another short story collection I bought on a whim is Lungs Full of Noise by Tessa Mellas. This won the Iowa Award for Short Fiction, which is a pretty prestigious award here in the U.S. for short fiction from the University of Iowa Press. And it's blurred by Julie Oringer, who has written some amazing short stories. It's also blurred by Matt Bell. So I'm looking forward to this. I don't know if it has a theme. There are some very playful stuff going on here. Some sort of non-traditional layout and narrative format. So I look forward to getting into diving in and seeing what this is all about. The cover is super fascinating. So yes, I am looking forward to this as well. Next, I picked up I Killed Giants, written by Joe Kelly, art by J.M. Kin Namura. This has won so many awards, y'all. Look at all that. It's crazy. The art's all black and white. It is adorable. I don't know what it's about. I've heard it's very emotional. Joe Kelly has written a deeply insightful story about a child using fantasy to navigate through a harsh reality. Barbara's character is a rarity among most graphic novels and comics. She is a damaged, not particularly likable person who is also a tangible, three-dimensional human being. At the end of her journey, by the time I got to the final pages, tears were streaming down my face, not the result of cheap sentimental manipulation. No, this story earned my tears. It was raw and beautifully honest. Well, I'm in. And finally, a book you're going to be seeing a full-length review on my channel very soon. It is the second comic I got this month in trade. I read a lot of single issues, but trade. Sunstone Volume 1, written and drawn by Stjepan Sejic. I gave it the good old college try there. This is a romantic comedy about our two main characters, Allie and Lisa, who enter in a BDSM relationship with each other, and it is amazing. But I think it deserves a lot more discussion, so look forward to that video from me soon. See you guys next time.